Hello students, welcome to IBP's Guide YouTube channel. At first, happy Holi to all of you. Wish you very happy and safe Holi. Today we will discuss LIC AU exams for ward replacement. As our SQL is continuing for LIC examination, and it will be ward replacement. Ward replacement means there is 10 question. There are 10 questions. The 5 questions are based on synonyms, and another 5 questions is based on antonyms. So let's move to question number 1. Direction 1 to 5. In each of the following questions, a sentence is given with a word given in bold in each. Choose a word from 5 options given below which can replace the bold word without changing the meaning of the sentence. So without changing the meaning of sentence, that means we have to take the synonymous word. Without changing the meaning of the sentence, that means this is the synonymous word. In LIC examination, there is a major part of vocabs. So guys, you have to prepare yourself at vocabularies also, specifically synonyms, antonyms, idioms, phrasal verbs. So here is our first question. The Sen brothers seem to lampoon successful people out of envy. Lampoon is bold, and we have to take the synonymous word among this 5 options. At first I want to discuss you what do you mean by lampoon. Lampoon means that is a very funny character, we can say that a cartoon that mocks or makes fun of well-known person, of well-known person. Sometime thinks. So in one word we can say that lampoon are those person who makes very much fun of well-known persons, they are called lampoon. So this is the word meaning of lampoon, and we get 5 option. Applaud. Applaud means to approve, express approval. To express approval. Second option is ridicule. Ridicule means that is the act of making fun of someone. The act of making fun of someone or something. Approve, you know that, what's the meaning of approve? Approve means that is acceptable something, acceptable. Plead, that is we can say that emotional way to ask something or someone in serious or emotional manner to ask. So we can write that the meaning of plead is to ask for something or someone in emotional way. And praise, to express good approval. So which can be the synonymous word? Guys, I hope it is clear to you. Lampoon means a character, a cartoon character which mocks and makes fun of well-known person. And ridicule, the act of making fun of someone or something. So applaud, approve, plead, praise, that is not the correct option. Our correct option is B, that is ridiculous. The ridiculous, ridicule and lampoon is are the synonymous word to each other. So we can replace the word lampoon, that is the ridicule. Question number 2. By trying to show off and asking those glib questions, Sina is just making herself look more ignorant. Here's the word is glib. What's the meaning of glib? Glib means said or done something too easily or carelessly. We can write in like this manner, said or done too easily or carelessly. That is called glib. Our first option is stuttering. Stuttering means, it's a very common word, stuttering means blocking of speech due to some disease, blocking of speech due to disorder of vocal cord. So that is called stuttering. Second is affectionate. Affectionate, I hope everybody knows that. What's the meaning of affection? Affection means feeling or showing love. So feeling or showing love. Third option is slick. Slick means that is to make something smooth. To make something smooth. So to make something smooth. We also can smooth and slippery. This is also correct option, slippery. Both A and B, and E option is inarticulate. Inarticulate means, just remember that guys, inarticulate means not able to express idea clearly. Express idea clearly and effectively in speech. Clearly and effectively in speech. So said or done too easily, that is glib. So which can be the synonymous word of glib? Definitely it will be slick. So our answer will be C. To make something, so by trying, show off and asking those glib, we can replace this word to slick. So correct option will be slick. Let's move to question number 3. Rakesh likes to pretend as if he didn't hear his mother ask him to go to shop. Here pretend. Pretend is our word and we have to put the synonymous word of pretend. Definitely not truth, approve, certain. These all are the wrong options. So our answer will be D. That is feign. Feign means to pretend or feel something affected by. So that's why our answer will be D. It's very easy. I hope easily you can give your answer. Question number 4th. Even would never hire an applicant if they had unreliable transportation. Even would never hire an applicant if they had unreliable transportation. So we have to put the synonymous word of unreliable. Unreliable. First option is forthright. Second option, durable. Third option, both A and B. Fourth option, unpredictable, and fifth option is measurable. Guys, I hope it is clear to you. Unreliable, the synonymous word of unreliable is, that is unpredictable. So that's why our answer will be D, that is unpredictable. Let's question number 5th. Hopefully Dr. Raghavan's quest for truth will lead them to find me innocent. So here also we have to give the synonymous word of quest. What do you mean by quest? Quest means a long and arduous search for something. Long time, if I am searching for long time something, that is called quest. So the meaning is a long or arduous search for something. So our option is here, options are that is retreat, indulge, influence, inquiry. Which can be the correct option? Definitely it will be inquiry. But here is also the word, that is indulge. Indulge is a very common word. Indulge means to allow or to have to or to do something. So we can write that to allow, to have or do something. that is called indulge. So our correct option will be D, that will be inquiry. So these five words are synonymous word of, that is word replacement definitely, but it all are the synonymous word. Next directions 6 to 10. In each of the following questions, a sentence is given with a word given in bold in each. Choose a word from the five options given below which is opposite in meaning to the word given in bold. The question number 1 to 5, that were the synonymous word. And here we have to give the antonyms, that is opposite meaning. Although the police had no proof, they were quick to surmise Mr. Roy had got his own daughter kidnapped. Although the police had no proof, they were quick to surmise Mr. Roy had got his own daughter kidnapped. Surmise, what it means with surmise? Surmise means guess. A blind think, a blind thought, a blind idea, that is called surmise. We can also say that they suppose that something is true without having evidence to confirm it. So something is true, but we have no any evidence, we have no any proof to confirm it. This is called surmise. So although the police had no proof, they were quick to surmise Mr. Roy had got his own daughter kidnapped. So we have to put the antonyms of surmise. First option we get deduce, second option we get hypothesize, third option we get fancy, fourth option we get know, and fifth option is presume. So what can be the antonyms of surmise? Surmise means guess. So definitely opposite word will be fancy. So our answer will be C. Fancy means that is completely imagination, based on imagination. So this is called fancy. So our answer will be C. The opposite word of fancy is C. Answer will be C. But here also a word that is hypothesize. Hypothesize means this is a very common word of vocabs. So what do you mean by hypothesize? Hypothesize means that is to suggest or to say something. To suggest or to make something, that is called hypothesize. So we can write that to suggest or to make. That is called hypothesize. So opposite word of surmise is fancy. Question number 7. The recent cyclone in Bengal left visible damage to houses across the state. That is damage. We have to put the opposite word of damage. And guys, I think it is clear to you. Jo cripple, impair and defile. These all three words of synonymous word of damage. So damage, the opposite word of damage definitely will be aid. Why? Because damage means that is inflict physical harm on something as to impair its value, usefulness or normal function. And aid, that is help or support someone and something to achievement of something. So here impair, in short we can say that impair means, the meaning of impair is to diminish the function, to diminish the function. And defile, to make impure, yeah, to make unclean, to make unclean or impure. So these all are the synonymous word, but aid will be the antonym. So correct option will be B. Rather than impute Rasika, Hansika will accept blame for a crime she did not commit. Rather than impute Rasika, Hansika will accept blame for a crime she did not commit. So here is the word that is impute. What do you mean by impute? At first we have to discuss that what is meaning of impute. Impute means to say or suggest something that someone is guilty. To say or suggest that someone is guilty. If we can write that in this manner, we can write to say or suggest that someone is guilty. That is called impute. First option we get exonerate, second option attribute, third option accuse, fourth option blame. C should be omitted. And fifth option is ensure. So it's clear to you that his answer will be exonerate. Why? Because exonerate means to prove that someone is not guilty. Is not guilty. So that's why our answer will be exonerate. Impute, someone is guilty. Exonerate, someone is not guilty. And rest of the options are also synonymous word. So we also can use that impute, that is represent something, especially something undesirable. It's also, we have to remember that, represent something, especially something undesirable, as being done or possessed by someone. So exonerate is an official body, absolve someone from blame or a fault or wrongdoing. Let's move to question number 9. Question number 9, while Susmita failed to include the main points in her answer, the teacher still gave her extra marks for her zeal. Zeal is a very common word. Zeal means a strong feeling of interest. There's a strong feeling of interest. Enthusiasm. Strong feeling of interest. That is enthusiasm. First option is devour. Second option is adore. Third option is diligence. Fourth option is inactivity, and fifth option is fervor. We have to put the antonyms. So I hope, guys, it is clear to you. Zeal, the opposite word of zeal is definitely inactivity. Very lazy person, that is inactive, and idleness, inactivity, state of being inactive. So zeal, energetic person, and inactivity is the opposite word. But we get options also, that is B, that is ardor. What do you mean by ardor? Ardor is a very common word, and very common word for competitive exams. So ardor means strong feeling of love. Just remember that ardor, strong feeling of love. That means order. So the opposite word of zeal is inactivity. Our answer will be D. Question number 10. Day after day, the factory workers had to toil hard without payment. Day after day, the factory workers had to toil hard without payment. So here, bold word is toil. And we have to put the antonyms of toil. Guys, what can be the answer? Toil means a long, strenuous, fatiguing labor. A long, strenuous, fatiguing labor. A long, strenuous, fatiguing labor. A very hard work and very fatiguing labor is called toil. First option is strive, second option is less, third option is plug, fourth option is drudge, fifth option is drive. So toil means work extremely hard or incessantly. So which can be the opposite word? Definitely laze. Laze means spend time in a relaxed and in very lazy manner, procrastination. So that's why our answer will be laze. But which is a meaning of strive? What's the meaning of strive? Strive means to try very hard. To try very hard. To try very hard. And plug, you know that plug is a features of computer system, plug and play. Drudgery, it also means to do very hard work. To do hard, as well as we can say that monotonous work. And driving any vehicle. So that's why our answer will be less. So these are 5 synonyms and 5 antonyms of holy gift. of yourself. Try to read it and try to remember it. That is a very common words and that is very easy words also. You can easily remember, but it's my request, it's my advice. These are the five options. You have also go through these five options also. Just don't see the answers. Just the correct option is less, so that we don't need any read to strive, drudge, not that. Just you have to go through the all options and synonyms. So in one day you can learn at least 50 words, 50 to 60 words, which is very essential for your LIC examination. I hope it will be very much help for you, and enjoy this session. Thank you. Have a nice day.